Namaste, welcome to Bhavana's Kitchen. Today I'm making laddu. Ganesh Chaturthi is going on right now, so I thought of preparing quick laddu today. And today's laddu recipe is a very traditional where I grew up. It is made from bakri. So here I have line of ingredients. Here I have 1 cup of chapati atta, wheat flour, about 1.5 tablespoon of rava, also known as soji, about 1 tablespoon of besan, chickpea flour, little bit more than 1/2 cup of gur, jaggery, 4 tablespoon ghee, clarified butter, milk as needed. Instead of milk, you can use simply water, but I always like things rich and flavorful. And for flavor, cardamom, elaichi. I'm going to put elaichi on side right now, and ghee, I need it divided. So here I have just take about 2 tablespoon of ghee into the pot. And the rest of the ghee I'm going to melt. Alright, so here I have ghee melted. So first step is to prepare the dough. Now into this bowl I'm going to prepare the dough, wheat flour, besan and rava. Mix it well. Perfect. Next, melted ghee and a little bit of milk. Add milk as you go so that you know how much to add, because you may not need all of it. And you can see that it has already started turning into dough. And I need a hard dough, so be very careful not to add too much of milk. So just a little milk at a time. And I'm just going to now keep on working without any milk. So it took only less than 1/4 cup of milk. There, the dough is ready in no time. Perfect. This is how I need. I'm going to divide into lemon size of a ball, like so. Next, it's time to roll and bake the bakris. Now, I prefer to bake all of the bakris at the same time and roll even at the same time. Now, there are a few ways you can do these days. If you have the pancake maker, you can bake so many bakris at a time. You can use oven. I have already shown how to bake bakri in an oven. Just roll the whole big bakri just like a pizza crust and then bake in the oven. So let's get started. Now when you roll the bakris, it doesn't have to be perfect, and don't worry about the cracks. We do need a cracks to bake inside of the bakri properly. So, do not even try to seal the cracks. That way, the inside of the bakri will bake properly. I'm also going to heat up pancake maker at 350 degrees Fahrenheit. So, just throw them onto the pancake maker. And bake until golden brown color. There are a few varieties of laddus made during Ganesh Chaturthi. This is just one of them. And by the way, these laddus can be made from leftover bakris as well. If you have a plain bakri leftover, and if it has got little crispy, crunchy, hard, then you can just crumble it and make laddus. When you see the bubbles like these on top, check the bottom to flip them on the other side. You can see nice golden brown color, and that is what we want. You may want to bake a little bit more. Look at this one. This is the perfect one. You want to see more golden brown specks. So I'm going to keep baking until I see golden brown specks like this. When done on the other side, brown like this, bring down onto the paper towel all the bakris. Let bakris cool down slightly. Bakris have cooled down slightly, and it's time to use another gadget, and it is food processor. Usually, traditionally, bakris are broken with a hand because it's a super duper easier to break with hands. Just throw all the bakris into the food processor. And ready to pulse. Make sure pulse on a medium speed. Take out into the same bowl I made the dough. I'm going to put this on the side, and now the next step is to prepare the mixture of gur and ghee. clarified butter that we divided earlier in this pot and good jaggery. So basically we need to melt jaggery. Make sure do not overcook this mixture. If you overcook, it's gonna get hard.
So here is the ghee and I have turned on the stove on a medium to high.
Ready to add jaggery. And now cook until jaggery is just melted. And I can see that it is melting fast. I'm going to go ahead and turn off the stove. Take it off of the stove. Add melted ghee and gur into the mixture, bakery mixture. Now mix with a spatula first quickly. Now at this time you can add flavors. Here I have cardamom. I also love to add poppy seeds, couscous in a laddus, but it's totally up to you. Some people add some dry fruits and nuts as well. When it is mixed nicely, it won't be hot. So at this time, mix well again with your hands. Start making laddus. You have to use a little bit of energy to press and you will see ghee also comes out a little bit on the top. Until that time, you wanna keep making, keep shaping. So using your fist tight, shape them into laddus. This is actually the method of making laddus. The hands should be kept like these. And if you don't want to make laddus, you can just throw as it is. It's called churmu. Alright, so the laddus are ready and ready to be offered to Ganesh ji. So I hope I made it easier for you to prepare Ganesh Chaturthi laddus. Thank you for watching and I will see you soon with another great recipe.